Fox College Football is presented by Geico. A picture perfect day here in the Pacific Northwest, 79 degrees as we get set for some football between Nicholls and number 3 Oregon here in Eugene. For more on this matchup, let's check in with the third member of our broadcast crew, Brady Papinga.
When you talk to Oregon's coaches about how they view their opponents on a week-in, week-out basis, they will tell you that their opponents to them are faceless opponents. And all that means for Oregon is that no matter who they're playing against, they're going to play their game. And their game is playing fast and scoring a lot of points. For Nicholls, it's all about deception today, guys, because that's the only shot they have to be competitive. They're going to have to use trick plays on offense in the form of reverses, double reverse passes, and on defense, they're going to have to be deceptive as well. Up to you, Justin.
All right, well, Charlie Stubbs, the head coach, who's also the offensive coordinator, he'll be calling all those trick plays, taking on number 3 Oregon. And their head coach, his first game, Mark Helfrich, last 4 years as the offensive coordinator. Oregon will receive, and Nicholls wants no part of DeAnthony Thomas. Instead, it's Keenan Lowe, and Lowe will take it up past the 35-yard line. James, how about the impact players in this one?
Well, now, Justin, they have no choice but to get themselves some DeAnthony Thomas. There he is, impact player. Of course, every 8.5 times he touches the ball, he scores a touchdown. Colt Lairla, possibly the best tight end in the nation. The safeties, two seniors, and Virginal and Lumar, so important to get this defense lined up all day long, and so important not to give up the big play. They are the last line of defense.
Josh Huff in motion on first down. It's Mariota. Mariota will throw to Huff, and Huff down the sideline. A couple of flags come flying in as he gets forced out of bounds. It's a pickup of 8 on first down, but let's see what this flag is. The referee today is Jack Wood.
There is no foul for an illegal man downfield. The pass was touched behind the line of scrimmage. Second down.
All right, so it's an 8-yard completion.
It was, took a long time to develop. And those linemen, as good as they are up front, tough for them to hold, but we'll keep it at 8.
On second and 2, it's DeAnthony Thomas on the carry. And Thomas has the first down across midfield, tackled by Ronald Tyler. There comes this offense.
And there's a guy on the edge, Justin, unblocked, flat-footed, and you can't make a play on DeAnthony Thomas. A lot of times on your toes, let alone not athletic.
It's Thomas again, and Thomas will pick up a couple of yards. Second down and 8.
How about Big Joe Bonner there? 73, 340 pounds, running down the little man from behind. Eddie Udo, another big nose tackle that's really got to have a big day there in the interior.
On second and 8, Mariota to pass. Completes the pass far sideline. Nice play by Braylon Addison to make a guy miss. Has a first down, a 15-yard play.
Here's where the excitement will get you. You're playing defense for Nicholls. You're so fired up to try to go light a guy up, come under control, and make a tackle at a 10-yard gain instead of trying to get a big kill shot there with a 5-yard gain.
Mariota with plenty of time. Mariota now will run with it down the sideline. Mariota gets pushed out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Now they're going to mark him out at the 4, a 27-yard run. Jordan Hanbury saves a touchdown. And again, Oregon not wasting any time. On first and goal, it's Thomas. And Thomas gets in. Touchdown, Ducks. DeAnthony Thomas had 11 rushing touchdowns last year. He's got 1 already this year. Just 1:31 for their first 6 points.
That's what they specialize in, scoring fast, under 2 minutes. Most of their touchdowns coming, and a really tough go for the Colonel defense. A couple times they felt like they had them stopped, a play extends, and then they get you and come and snap it right away. Nobody was set, an easy touchdown.
Alejandro Maldonado for the extra point, 7-0 Oregon. Marcus Mariota. He can do it with his arm. He can do it with his legs. Nobody's open. He'll run with it. 27 yards. And DeAnthony Thomas will take it in for the touchdown. And his fans, his team, they're happy. They lead by 7. Year 45 of the 83 scoring drives that resulted in touchdowns for Oregon were scored in under 2 minutes. Right now, they're 1-for-1.
That's right. And guess what? We get it week one and week two like that because leading the nation last year, Oregon and Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State next week here on Fox Sports 1 against UT San Antonio. Matt Logan will kick off. Damone Bolts and Kerry Fortson are back deep for Nicholls. Taken at the 4-yard line by Fortson. Fortson making a couple of guys miss, a good return as he gets back up to the 27. James, how about the impact players on this side of the ball?
Well, you'll take that right there. On this side of the football, Marcus Washington and Damone Bolt are the playmakers on this offense. When it's there, they got to get it, and they've got to take care of that football. And how about Ifo and Terrence? Ifo, Ekpre, Olomu. And Terrence Mitchell, probably the best corner tandem in the nation, and they've got a secondary all across the board, safeties as well, that are dynamite.
Marcus Washington in the backfield on first down. Bo Hebert, the quarterback. A play action rollout, and his pass is incomplete, intended for Washington. Bo Hebert, that name may sound familiar. His father, Bobby Hebert.
Well, and if he's anything like Papa, he may be a little kooky enough just not to care how big a stage this is and how good this Oregon team is. They're going to try to roll him out, throw some underneath passes, give him some confidence, and that offensive line as well.
On second and 10, it's Abel keeping it, nowhere to go, gets hit in the backfield for a loss of 4. Leads us to our first game break. Studio in Los Angeles. Patrick O'Neill, the Lowe's Never Stop Improving Game Break. Good to hear from you again, Patrick.
Justin, my pleasure. Thanks, pal. The Golden Domers, 14th ranked Notre Dame, hosting Temple. Tommy Reese has taken over for Everett Golson, a case of deja vu. Reese to Davaris Daniels for 2 touchdowns. And Brian Kelly, guys, looking for career win number 200. Justin and James.
Third down and 14. Hebert's pass is tipped, incomplete. Tipped by Taylor Hart in a 3-and-out forced on the first defensive possession of the game for Oregon, and this is exactly what Nicholls did not want to have happen.
You're right. They didn't even eat any clock up, and so now you've got a defense that right off the bat was on its heels the entire series, the whole 137. Now they got to pop right back up and try to do it again. But you can't get yourself in third down and 14 situations against a defense like this.
Connor Freeu will punt. Brandon Addison is back deep. Addison a chance to return, and he gets hit. Great downfield coverage on special teams by Nicholls. 7-0, Oregon leads here in the first quarter. And they're coming out for just their second possession of the game. Nothing. Oregon leads. Time now for the 4 keys to the game.
Well, Colonels, it's not going to be easy, but you can't beat the Colonels. Don't turn it over against a team that led the nation in turnover margin last year and getting back to cruising altitude. When we last saw Justin, this Oregon football team, they were in the Fiesta Bowl doing just this, running the football and winning football games, and it seems like they have gotten back up there in a hurry.
That's not what you expect to see out of DeAnthony Thomas, a 12-yard run. Second effort, dragging some tacklers. Now first and 10 from the 41. Play action, Mariota. And that pass is incomplete low, intended for Keenan Lowe. Mark Helfrich, his first game as the head coach here for the Oregon Ducks. The offensive coordinator the last 4 years
And again, the big question is, how will this offense run comparable to last year or the previous 4 years?
Well, he insists, and those players as well. There's not much that's changing.
On 2nd and 10, the handoff to Thomas. And Thomas, another spin move, gets up to the 48-yard line, picks up 8, tackled by T.J. Lumar.
And Justin Brady hit on it right off the top of the show. Faceless opponent. It's just the same, a few different faces for this Oregon offense, but they're doing the same exact thing.
Up the middle again with Thomas, and Thomas moving the change. Cole Frazier with the stop, a 3-yard run by DeAnthony Thomas. This is why you don't change many things if you're Oregon.
That's right, that's under Chip Kelly with Mark Helfrich, an Oregon boy through and through as the offensive coordinator. Now it's Scott Frost.
1st and 10, Mariota. Looking down the field, taking a shot down the sideline. Overthrows his intended receiver, Darrell Hawkins.
Well, Mariota, we know what he can do on the ground. Just 75% of the time last year, they ran the football. Everybody thinks about him flying up and down the field. A lot of times, it comes from the handoffs. It comes from stuff in the backfield. And Mariota, back-to-back throws, has been off the mark. That's way too easy of a touchdown, and that's the kind of throw you're going to have to hit here in a month or so.
2nd down and 10. It's Thomas again, and Thomas got hit hard that time. A 6-yard run. Devin Bovey with a tackle.
With everybody, including us, talking about how small DeAnthony Thomas is, I think he's taking offense to it. He is running as hard as can be. Look at
him right now. DeAnthony Thomas gets dragged down. Another 1st down. Ronald Tyler stops him after a run of 15. Let's bring Brady Papenga in. Brady, what are you seeing down there on the field?
Well, it's a lot of what you guys have already touched on with DeAnthony Thomas. He's more of an outside guy, but he's doing a nice job running the ball up between the tackles, running hard, keeping his pad levels down, and keeping those legs churning. And for a guy of slight of height and weight that he is, he's running the ball pretty well in between the tackles.
Empty backfield as Marshall came in, split out wide. The pass complete. Brandon Addison breaks one, dives. Touchdown. Seven-yard touchdown pass for Marcus Mariota. Another touchdown drive in under 2 minutes. Braylon Addison. He had 3 touchdowns last year, his 1st this year. Alejandro Maldonado on. That's Matt Wogan now on for the extra point. Already 14-0 in this game. Number 3 Oregon leading Nicholls. We knew about their offense coming in. James, you said they had to reach their soaring altitude. So far, so good. Matt Wogan will kick off with Damon Bolton, Kerry Fortson back deep. This will be taken at the 4 by Fortson. Fortson, another good return. His 1st one was 22 yards. This time, a 24-yard return. Brady and James, you guys are linebackers. What are you seeing right now from this Oregon offense?
What I loved about that last play by Braylon Addison, and James, you can appreciate this being a Southern guy. He gave that nickel defender a little shake and bake.
That's what they do, isn't it? But I feel for these defensive backs because, Brady, you look a couple plays prior, and they run right by him. Mariota's off the mark. So you soften up the defense, and you sit right down in front of him. Either way, it's a pretty easy touchdown, isn't it?
It is, and that's what you get with Oregon.
On 1st down, Hebert comes back to Marcus Washington, and Washington able to slip a tackle, get across the 40,
And he'll be marked out the 42, a 14-yard completion. Brian Jackson with the tackle, but a first down for Nicholls.
What a big play for Nicholls. They didn't get anything the first time out there. They, you know, finally, okay, now the big stage, all the jitters are out of our system. They need to get a couple first downs. Maybe not go all the way down and punch it in the end zone, although they'd like to. Move this football, give the defense a rest.
Hand off to Washington up the middle, bounces off one. And he'll be marked down at the 49-yard line, a 7-yard run.
Well, and here's Brian Jackson. Sat down with him yesterday, and look at the form. You talk about breaking down in open space. When you go against DeAnthony Thomas in practice every day, tackling a guy like Marcus Washington, who isn't bad, is really easy. Brian Washington, really a treat to listen to him talk ball yesterday afternoon.
Second down and three. Washington again. And Washington has the first down. Today's game is also being broadcast in Spanish for the Spanish version of our game. Please tune in to Fox Deportes.
And for those fans, muy bueno, 44. Marcus Washington, Coach Stubbs told us, this is a special guy, this is a good back, and you know what? Get me four, get me three, get me four, and do it three times in a row, do it four times in a row, and we can march down this football field. Impressive drive here for Nicholls.
Washington in motion. Hebert rolling out, throws on the run, incomplete as he throws it out. The pressure applied by Eric Armstead, a defensive tackle for this Oregon Ducks team, who is a high school All-American. He also plays on the basketball team here at Oregon.
Hey, and Bo, that's fine. You're moving the football, throw it away. Don't take a big hit and drop that ball on the turf. Don't try to force something in there. A smart play by a guy in his first start, and obviously a very tough environment. And he's just happy to be out there finally after a couple big injuries. Otherwise, he would have started a lot of games, maybe.
Second down and 10 here for the Colonels. Pressure coming. Abel steps up, gets rid of it, but also took a hit. Marcus Washington, the intended receiver, third and 10 coming up.
Well, where'd the pressure come from? Deion Jordan's gone, but it still came from the edge. Here you see the left side of your screen. That's Ricky Hamuli coming off the edge, and there was room up front. That's one thing when you watch these Oregon pass rushers last year, you always get tons of pressure off the edge. Up front, a three-step drop, there's not always a lot of pressure right up the gut in the quarterback's face.
Third and 10. Pressure coming again, and there it goes down. DeForest Buckner with the sack. A 6-yard loss on the play.
Well, here it comes right from the middle to DeForest Buckner. Only two starts last year. One of the many new faces up front. Isaac Remington, of course. Deion Jordan, the highest NFL draft pick ever to come out of Oregon. So just like Barner on the offensive side, DeAnthony Thomas has done a good job in the starting role there. And we've got some guys here who have started this season good, too, defensively.
Braylon Addison calls for a fair catch, makes it at the 9. Everyone talks about the offense here at Oregon. How about the defense? They don't get much love, but Brian Jackson says this is how you're supposed to tackle in the open field.
Mortgage.
Beautiful landscaping around Autzen Stadium, 14-0 Oregon leading Nicholls. Time for KFC stat comparison. We look at a couple of receivers for this Oregon Ducks team. Josh Hoff, Braylon Addison, what they did last year. Addison already a touchdown here today.
Well, Frost telling us, Scott Frost, the offensive coordinator, Addison has had an unbelievable fall camp. We saw him in action already. Unable to pull this one down low. One thing, though, when you look at those two, as we compare the receivers, Addison's a young guy. He's a sophomore. Makes a big, flashy play. One thing that he can get more than anything from Josh Huff is the way they block down the football field. Very tough receivers.
Second down and 10. That pass is incomplete for Braylon Addison. And it almost looked like a lateral, but it wasn't. So it'll be third down and 10 here for the Ducks from their own 10-yard line.
Well, we saw a little bit of life from that Colonel offense. Can they get a stop here? Can they get a big stand on third and 10 now defensively?
Mariota stepping up down the middle of the field, and that is complete to Josh Huff. On third and 10, a 46-yard completion.
If you're going to bring three, Justin, put a little bit of pressure all day long. You can't expect to run with these speedsters that deep into the play.
DeAnthony Thomas gets shoved out of bounds at the 29-yard line, a 17-yard run for Thomas. Talk about a backbreaker for this Nicholls defense. You have them third and 10 at their own 10 in a big 46-yard completion, and now this offense is rolling again.
And Justin, and they played it well in the secondary. They just couldn't get any pressure on Mariota, and he dropped it in there that time. We saw him miss a couple. That one was right on the money.
First and 10. It's the handoff to Thomas. Thomas to the outside, now cuts it back in. And Thomas has another first down. DJ Lumar with a tackle. An 11-yard run for DeAnthony Thomas.
Well, DeAnthony Thomas makes a lot of things happen on his own, but when you look at the explosive plays of this offense, there have got to be receivers blocking downfield. That time it was Darryl Hawkins to set the edge and get the first down to help.
And we've got a flag here on first and 10. It's going to be a false start here against Oregon.
5-yard penalty, still first down.
So here's the big third and 10, and here in the slot is Josh Huff. We just mentioned him and how well he blocks. Oh, yeah, by the way, he can run too. And not bad defensively again. You're in decent position against these speedsters in the hip pocket.
First and 15, it's Thomas. Thomas cuts it back, and he'll walk into the end zone. Second touchdown of the game for DeAnthony Thomas, this time a 23-yard run. Alejandro Maldonado on for the extra point. 21 points here in the first quarter for Oregon. 90 yards and 86 seconds. DeAnthony Thomas with a cutback. A 22-yard touchdown run for the Black Mamba.
Wait. Life is unpredictable. You could be injured in an accident that wasn't your fault simply because you stepped left.
College football here on Fox. Second quarter, Oregon leading 24-0 over Nicholls. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. 24 points scored in that first quarter by the Ducks. That high-flying offense put up 235 yards. Quarterback draw for Kalen Henderson, and Henderson gets up to the 18-yard line. Tackled by Tony Washington. Fourth down coming up. And it looks like Nicholls will try to get on the board here. Andrew Dolan out for a 35-yard field goal attempt. Look at the difference, which is pretty much what you had expected coming in.
Here's a senior led the team with 51 points last year. It would be a nice three to start your 2013 score.
From 35 yards out, and Dolan puts the Nicholls Colonels on the board. A 35-yard field goal for Nicholls. Marcus Mariota, a first-team All-Pac-12 quarterback last year, back on the field when we come back. Johns Hopkins Medicine and Stomp Out Bullying. We're raising awareness for these organizations all year long through all Fox Sports networks and platforms. We're proud to support the work they do to make a difference in people's lives. To learn more, please visit foxsportssupports.com. Andrew Dolan, who just connected from 35, will kick off with DeAnthony Thomas back deep. And again, they want no part of Thomas. As this one will go out of bounds at around the 31, the flag will come out, and Oregon will have the ball at the 35.
You know, Justin, there's nobody there for that ball. But
kickoff out of bounds, kicking tee. 5-yard penalty will be enforced. In the previous spot, there will be a re-kick.
Smart move by Oregon as well. Make them re-kick it. With this team, you never know what can happen.
But, Justin, if I'm Nicholls, I'm doing the same kick and telling my cover guys to get down there because there's nobody on there waiting for it. If a guy in red can get to it, it's Colonel football.
Well, now, after that 5-yard penalty, Nicholls will have to kick off from their own 30.
Onside kick them right here. Catch them off guard. Again, we talked about it. Nothing to lose. You got guys, all right, going through the motions. I'm going to turn and burn one more time. See if you can get them. Coach Stubbs promised us a little bit of trickery, didn't he?
Dolan this time kicking it away from Thomas. Keenan Lowe. And Lowe has some room down the sideline with some blockers. Lowe returns it all the way inside the 35-yard line. And that's why you want this team to re-kick it. Give these players a chance.
And Justin, if we see the beginning of this play, watch that front line. Look at them, make sure the ball is kicked. They wouldn't have fallen for it. That's a well-coached special teams unit, not just up front, but it's pretty easy to coach guys that can flat out fly like Keenan Lowe when you've got guys blocking for him up the field like that.
A 49-yard return by Keenan Lowe. Byron Marshall in the backfield now for Oregon with Josh Huff. Huff splits out. Mariota rolling out to his right. Throws. Is it complete? It is. Keenan Lowe making the catch along the sideline.
Little extra cheer here for a Portland guy, local guy, and what a great job to focus. And it certainly looks like the left foot was down. They'll take another look at it. But a rocket thrown by Mariota where only Lowe could get to it.
And the reason for the stoppage there is because that play resulted in a first down. They originally had second down. Now it's first and 10 here for Oregon. And let's hold up again. We're going to review this.
This play was a completed pass. Yardage gain was deemed to be sufficient for a first down. The previous play is under review.
What do you think?
Well, I think it's a good job by a receiver who's covered. His quarterback's in trouble to come back and help him. It looks like, I don't know that he's got it.
No, watch the knee and the sideline. Oh, and his, watch where the knee is. I think he's out of bounds. I think it's an incomplete pass.
This is going to be a better look, I think, for us right here. The foot did hit first, but I think by the time the ball got there, the knee was down as well, and the knee was definitely on the white. And as they look at it, Justin, back at the beginning of that play, you had some pressure from the end for Nicholls. You've got to maintain those rush lanes. You can't let Marcus Mariota go get outside and buy himself 10 extra seconds. You can't do that to your secondary. And if you look at that play early, and these guys are covered.
The pressure was applied by Chris Berman. The coach is waiting for the ruling.
After review, it will be determined that the pass was incomplete. The ball will be returned to the previous spot. It will be second down.
Good job by the officials to get this one right. So far, the couple of plays, they've gone to the review three times, and all three times they've gotten it right.
Including an ejection to Terrence Mitchell, a great corner on defense for the Ducks. If you weren't with us earlier, there's one player missing right now. It's a big lead right now, but in a tight game, that's going to hurt a team this year in college football.
On second down and 11, it's Marshall. And Marshall burst through with that speed up the 24-yard line. Chris Berman with a tackle, a 7-yard run.
A little juice for number 9 as well. It doesn't just stop with number 6. And everybody talking about Thomas Tyner, the fantastic freshman from Oregon. This guy can go.
Third and 3. Mariota again to Marshall. And Marshall has the first down, broke a tackle, but could not walk the tightrope. Out of bounds, Devin Bovee. 12-yard run for Marshall.
Justin, do you see how easy it looks on back-to-back plays for Marshall to get out there on the edge? A defense, eventually they're going to start cheating to try to stop the bleeding right there, and that's when you hit them with a play-action pass or misdirection.
Mariota, the pass to the end zone, and it's incomplete. Good hit by Byron Cobb to knock it out of the hands of Josh Huff.
A good clean hit, and this is exactly what I'm talking about. Now you go play action pass, trying to pull everybody from the secondary, these backers up against the stop. The run doesn't happen.
Mariota again, now forced down, being chased. Mariota has that speed, has a block, touchdown. Braylon Addison again with the block as a wide receiver. Twelve-yard touchdown run by Marcus Mariota, and he could thank his wide receiver for getting into the end zone.
Braylon Addison has a big touchdown catch, but what I'm impressed the most with is how he used his hands to block on two now touchdown runs for his offense.
Matt Logan on for the extra point. They were short a man.
Well, getting up to cruising altitude. See, these are the things, Justin.
And here comes the flag. So that's some turbulence?
A little bit.
That's right.
Offense, 5-yard penalty. Remains the try for point.
And for Cameron Hunt there, who came running out late, he's not free to move about the cabin or do anything. He'll be getting chewed a little bit. But those are the kind of things that you like to clean up, especially for a first-year head coach in an opener like this.
Wogan's extra point splits the uprights. 31-3, Oregon leading Nicholls. It looked like a touchdown, but a nice play by Byron Cobb knocked it out of Josh Huff's hands. So Mariota will run it himself. 31-3, Oregon on top of Nicholls here in the second quarter. It's 31-3. Oregon has 4 touchdowns and a field goal in a total of 7 minutes, 11 seconds. Nicholls has 3 points on a 5:48 scoring drive. That's unbelievable.
I'll tell you what's unbelievable is that old phone, $62 million in renovation, all the technology, everything is modern and pretty as can be, and you still got the old red phone on the side.
Matt Logan kicks this one out of the end zone for a touchback. Time for a game break. Let's go back to Patrick O'Neill.
Hey, Justin, thanks very much. Oklahoma State, Mississippi State, Cowboys passing game non-existent, so J.W. Walsh says, yeah, I'll do it myself. That touchdown after a 46-yard gain. So a pretty good matchup, Big 12 SEC Week 1. Justin and James, back to you guys in Eugene.
Thanks, Patrick. We'll see Oklahoma State next week in San Antonio against UT San Antonio. But right now here in Eugene, 31-3, Oregon leading Nicholls. Again, if you're joining us late, Terrence Mitchell knocked out Bo Hebert, the starting quarterback. He was ejected for targeting, so Kalen Henderson is in. On first down, little play action. Henderson rifles one to Marcus Washington, who gets upended, but picks up 8 yards on first down.
Good job by Henderson to step in there. They had him covered down the field. He checks down underneath. And, you know, this is a guy who played at Tulsa. He, under Bill Blankenship, a great offensive mind, great football coach there in Tulsa. So he's played some big-time ball over the years before transferring.
Charlie Stubbs was excited about this young man, the fact that he provides a dual threat. On second and two, he keeps it. He's able to move the pile and move the chains. Raheem Castle with the tackle, but a 3 yard run on second and two. First and 10 here for Nicholls.
Justin, we came back from break and we looked at time of possession. And that's one thing that Chip Kelly said that he cared nothing about. If you watch Nicholls, the first time they had the ball, they came out through a couple incomplete passes and only ate up 107. The fact that they now have some minutes under their belts, the fact that they are moving the ball and moving the chains against this defense has to feel good.
Hand off again is to Washington. And Tony Washington is right there to throw him backwards. No gain, got back the line of scrimmage.
You think that guy's got some big Nikes to fill here in Eugene? The junior trying to replace the highest drafted player in school history in Deion Jordan, and a good job by his buddies in the middle to jam it all up and make it second down and 10.
I also think the town that he's from in California is one of my favorite to pronounce in all the country.
Give it to me.
Rancho Cucamonga.
Oh, you're awesome.
Second down and 10. Henderson rolling out, throws, completes the pass to Eric Buchanan. And Buchanan up to the 44, tackled by Avery Patterson, an 8 yard pickup.
Here we go, continue. Just get me some move, keep moving and stay ahead of the game. Stay ahead of these chains, and now you give yourself a third down and short.
And more importantly, keep that clock moving. Want to shorten this game as much as possible. 1 for 5 on third down so far in this game. The Ducks asking their fans to make some noise.
Unbalanced.
Swing it out to Washington, who has the first down. Washington gets hit at the 46 by Brian Jackson. Another good open field tackle, but a 10-yard completion. First down.
There you go, moving those chains across midfield. Charlie Stubbs was an SEC offensive coordinator of the year at Alabama. A lot of shifting last year, a lot of motion last year. We haven't seen it as much. Here we see an unbalanced look. Again, something that they probably haven't seen at Oregon. That's the luxury of playing a team in week one as opposed to Oregon State at the end of last year.
The end of last year, and it resulted in a 77-3 loss for Nicholls. Dalton Hilliard now in the game. He takes the handoff, and he gets wrapped up in the backfield by Locombo. A loss of 2, second and 12 coming up. You mentioned Charlie Stubbs being that SEC offensive coordinator of the year. That year, didn't something happen at Florida too?
Fortunately, I was already out of town, but my Gators, we had put together, hey, our crew, one of the longest home-winning streaks of all time. I think it was 35 or something like that, and dang, he brought his offense in there and beat my Gators in the swamp. Thanks for reminding me, though.
I just wasn't sure. I had to refresh my memory. Well, that was certainly some movement. Nick Scalfo.
False start. Offense number 85. 5 yard penalty. Still second
I wonder
down.
If Scalfo was saying, hey, I'm open. 31-3 here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga. James, of course, captain linebacker on the 96 national championship team at Florida. Brady Papinga, 8-year NFL vet, played his college ball at BYU. And we've got a break here with 9:11 to go here in the second quarter.
It-
It has been all Ducks so far, 31-3. The number three team in the land leading Nicholls with 9:11 to go here in this second quarter. Second and 17 here for the Colonels. Marcus Washington back in. Play action. Henderson with time. Rolling out, looking for something. Good coverage. And now he gets hit. Taylor Hartz. Move the ball 2 yards, but Henderson is in because Hebert is out. Brady, what do you know about Hebert?
Yeah, I checked on Hebert. I talked to their head trainer. And Bo Hebert is going to be held out. They were just taking precautions. They're running him through all the concussion protocol, but they feel like he could go back in, but they're just not going to send him in right now. So he's healthy, but they're just taking all precautions necessary.
Well, glad to know that he's healthy. Maybe we will see him later in this game. Third and 15 here for Nicholls. Dalton Hilliard Jr. Empty backfield. He's put out wide. Henderson steps up. He gets hit, fumbles, but it looks like he's able to bring it back in. Tony Washington hit him, forced the fumble, but great awareness by Henderson.
Well, Kalen Henderson, he should have found out the previous play. Look, 15 seconds, 20 seconds. These receivers aren't going to run from these DBs. Tuck it and go right now. Go get 10 yards. And let's make another decision, see if we need to go for it on fourth down again. Instead, he waits too long, and then they catch back up with the speed up front.
Connor Freeu will punt. Braylon Addison is back at his own 10. Did he touch the ball? It doesn't look like he did. And it will be Oregon ball. A big hit by Tony Washington on Kalen Henderson. Forced the fumble. Henderson able to recover, but Oregon now with the ball at their own 10, leading by 28. Coming up on the Pizza at Halftime Report with Rob Stone, Coy Wire, and Petros Papadakis. Johnny Football, he's back in action. Urban Meyer, he's still unbeaten with those Buckeyes. Unbelievable. And Notre Dame takes the field. Tommy Reese as the quarterback. De'Anthony Thomas back in here. On first down, the pass to Colt Laiola. And Laiola, that stud tight end with his first catch of the afternoon, picks up 13.
A capital S, capital T, capital U, capital D stud at tight end for Oregon. Blocking and catching the football. It's going to be a huge year for the junior.
A couple of flags come flying in.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Again, these are the issues that you're trying to work out in this first game of the season for Oregon. First and 15 now for the Ducks. Coming up on 7 minutes to go in this first half. Mariota. Down, nice pass, completes to Josh Huff. And Huff is out of bounds at the 49-yard line, a 31-yard completion.
When you can run it at will, you freeze everybody on that defense, and then you play action pass, all the receivers run by him.
And now it's De'Anthony Thomas up the middle. And Thomas gets tackled by Chris Lorden, picks up 5.
They are just now setting those chains. Grassu, Hieronis Grassu, the center, over the ball right now, told us yesterday, I yell at the refs all the time, hey, we got to go, man.
Second and 5. Mariota keeps it. Mariota with a 4-4 speed. Nobody's touching him. Touchdown. Six-yard touchdown run by Marcus Mariota after a 22-yard touchdown run earlier in this half.
Oh,
Alejandro Maldonado on for the extra point. And in case you're wondering about quick strikes, how about 90 yards in 65 seconds? Earlier they went 90 yards in 86 seconds.
Well, this is Oregon offense to a T. The pace, they picked it back up. It had been dragging a little bit, both offensively and defensively. When you've got two guys that can commit on this zone option, on this zone read option, when you got two guys that commit defensively to the back, then they've got you. And Mariota's going to make them pay right here. Watch. You've got one body inside that's going to go. This linebacker has to stay out of the junk, has to keep himself free because they do such a good job of washing up front. And Mariota making him pay, the sophomore. We were wondering what he was going to do for an encore this year, and he's giving you a little taste here early on.
Two rushing touchdowns in the game. He had five all of last year. 38-3, Oregon leading.
You know, Justin, they've been working with Marcus. They're trying to find, give us a negative, anything. Well, maybe he's not vocal enough. Nice guy, quiet guy. Well, he can't slide, and he cannot slide. As good of an athlete as he is, they've sent him over to the baseball team. They don't want to get him banged up, but when you keep running scot-free to the end zone, you don't have to slide.
Logan's kickoff. Tyler takes it at the one. And Tyler, a good return, gets flipped over at the 23-yard line. Josh. This Oregon offense, people have really talked about this offense for the last 10 years or so. Look at what they've done by the decade. 16.9 in the 70s, now 47.5 from 2010 and on.
And it's so good to see this Oregon school taking care of their own people, each hire from within there to the head coach.
The pitch to Washington. And Washington, they have fumbled the ball, and let's see what we have here. The pylon, the scrum. And it will be Oregon football. Derek Malone recovers the football. And Charlie Stubbs can only shake his head.
Justin, for all the good that Marcus Washington has done today, he had the one hold on what would have been a touchdown run. And here, this one, they need to come back and look at this one. This is very late on the strip. And I'm not so sure his knees weren't down. And I sure hope for a guy who's fought so hard.
I think his knee was down. There's the knee down. Then the ball comes loose. I think this will be overturned again. Ricky Havili Hamuli forced the fumble. You know, if you're looking at Marcus Washington right there, it wasn't as if he was careless with the ball at all.
Five 11, 215 pounds. He's a squatty body, strong guy, and he had it in there tight. There wasn't any air in between, unlike Bo Hebert earlier. But one thing's for sure, these Ducks go after the football. Nick Aliotti has him trying to create these turnovers.
We're going to bring back in Mike Pereira. Mike, on this play, what exactly are the officials looking for?
Well, I think they're looking for that knee being down, which I think it is. You kind of process this thing together when you look at the video as it moves and you get the sense of the rip out after the knee is down. So I do think they reversed this to putting him down. Again, if you leave it in motion, watch the action of the ball being ripped out comes after that knee is on the ground. So yeah, I think you put the ball down here and hope we don't give it back to Nicholls, and then let's hope we don't have any more stoppages and we can
what
get
are you saying? You don't want to join us anymore, Mike?
Man alive. I tell you, you've got ejections, you've got replay stoppages, you've got certainly a one-sided game. Good thing they got you two pros to keep these to keep everybody interested in this.
Well, thanks, Mike. We appreciate it. Let's see what the call is here on the field.
After review, the runner was down prior to losing possession. The ball will be returned to the offense. It will be second and 8 at the 25-yard line.
So it's second and 8. It is overturned. No fumble. Nicholls retains the ball.
You know, Mike gives us a compliment. I'm going to give him one in return. And what a great launch to Fox Sports 1 about 3 weeks ago in California, our big football seminar. And Mike gets up there and basically goes over these new rules. And, you know, Brady Papinga and I sit next to each other, two meathead linebackers, just groaning, oh, this isn't football anymore. And Mike says, player safety outweighs competitive aspect of the game, period. If you don't like it, it's too bad. And think about that, fans, when you talk about the targeting. These are kids out there. We want to keep them safe.
Henderson on the rollout, throws, completes the pass to Vaughn Bolts. And Bolts with forward progress picks up 7. Derek Malone with his third tackle of the game. I like what Kalen Henderson brings to the offense here for Nicholls.
Absolutely. Look at him throw it in right here and hold to a great target at receiver. And this is what he does. We've seen what he can do with his legs. In a multi-dimensional quarterback, if he can only do one thing, and you know, hey, as a defensive coordinator, I can go and I can stop him from throwing the football. But when he can also run it, that's where the headaches come in.
3rd and 1, Washington in. Washington on the carry, and he will get the first down.
Brady Papinga, speaking with Chris Ault over the years, the godfather of this pistol offense, he brought up something that I didn't realize. In the pistol formation, the linebacker can't see that back behind the quarterback. And here it's interesting because they just need a yard, and you're dancing trying to find out where he's going.
Well, you know, James, your dad, Jim Bates, was an excellent teacher of linebacking. The one thing he taught is you got to look at the mannerisms of the back, and that'll tell you the blocking scheme. But like you just mentioned, in the pistol formation, from a stack linebacker perspective, you can't see his mannerisms. You can't see if he's going to take a jab step, and that is to the disadvantage of the linebacker and his ability to react to the run.
Justin, I can't wait.
76, 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Until Jack Wood has finished speaking.
Yeah. Now I can wait. And again, Colonels beating Colonels, the ongoing theme here, unfortunately. But Brady and Justin, I can't wait until Jim Bates, my dad, Brady was talking about, gets to a game and those two hang out down on the field together. They were together in Green Bay. Oh, you talk about a great, great couple of guys talking ball right there.
James, you're another chip off the old block. You don't fall too far from the tree there, James.
1st and 15 now here for Nicholls. Henderson over the middle, completes to his receiver who took a big hit. Terry Lucas Jr. And the hit again laid by Locombo. Locombo, a 3rd-round pick in the CFL.
John Neal is the defensive back coach. We've seen backups come and make great plays already in this game, especially in the open field. In a day and age when you don't get a lot of tackling, you don't get a lot of practice, they want to keep these guys healthy and safe. And here you've got guys that can tackle in the open field like that that are backups. That's why this is a special Ducks defense.
A redshirt freshman out of Chandler, Arizona, 3rd and 9. Anderson drops back. Forced out of the pocket. Ricky Havili-Hemuli, a loss of 9 on the sack.
They had big Ricky at 315 pounds in that Fiesta Bowl standing up in a linebacker 2-point stance. Here he comes from his natural defensive line spot. He's not going to be denied.
When you can rip a guy down to the turf by just the shirt, the jersey, that's pretty strong.
It looked like it was 2 fingers, too. He was pinching.
Free use punt. Addison from the 36. Addison down to the outside, and he gets shoved out of bounds. This week, UFC Wednesday comes to Fox Sports 1 as third-ranked light heavyweight Glover Teixeira takes on Ryan Bader. Then it's the season premiere of The Ultimate Fighter featuring rival coaches Ronda Rousey and Misha Tate. UFC Wednesday brings you 8 straight hours of great UFC action beginning at 4 p.m. Eastern with the UFC fight. Oregon with the ball with 1:56 to go in this half at the 44 of Nicholls. I wonder if they have enough time to put more points on the board.
Well, under 2 minutes. That's their specialty, isn't it? A quick hit.
Thomas splits out. Mariota comes to Huff. And Huff tried to go forward, got shoved back. Ronald Tyler with a tackle. It'll be a 4-yard gain for Josh Huff.
Great job by Ronald Tyler to fight to get to that outside shoulder. That's where all your buddies are. You got 10 buddies on the inside.
Oh, that's a dangerous pass knocked in the air. Byron Cobb. Cobb read that one perfectly.
Justin, you seen the water boy?
Of course.
You see, where Rob Schneider, when they lose Bobby Boucher, is, we suck again. You'd think that these guys from Louisiana would have that mindset. Every reason, just fold up. Hey, let's go on back. It's 38-3. They are playing hard, and this is fun to watch the Colonels right now. Look at
them. DeAnthony Thomas. DeAnthony Thomas gets gang tackled at the 39. Lorenza Young, the first one there to make contact. And so now you're looking at 4th and 5. Might as well go for it.
Well, in this is a situation. This is a team that's loved to go for it on 4th down. So here's a chance. Here's a
timeout taken by Oregon. Look at the day here for DeAnthony Thomas. And we still have a minute to go here in the first half. 13 carries, 112 yards. And 2 touchdowns. And don't forget, coming up on the Pizza at Halftime show, we've got an update. Johnny Manziel back in action. Urban Meyer still unbeaten at Ohio State. Quarterback situation, no Golson at Notre Dame, but Tommy Rees getting the start, looking pretty good as well. That's all coming up on the Halftime show. 4th and 5. Thomas in the backfield, Mariota in the shotgun. Little play action. Mariota dancing around. Mariota still dancing. Down the sideline, incomplete to Huff. And a penalty flag comes flying in. There are a couple of penalty flags on the play.
Well, first of all, a holding or receiver downfield, you would think, with a play that takes what seemed like 60 seconds to finally happen.
That play took longer than some scoring drives.
There were 2 flags thrown on the play. The first flag was for a potential illegal touching. There is no foul for illegal touching. The receiver was forced out of bounds. Ineligible receiver downfield on the offense. That penalty will be declined. First down.
Give credit to the Colonels' defense here. Came up with a stop here after great starting field position for Oregon.
And Justin, good coverage downfield. What are you going to do? You don't blitz them, so you can't really get there with your initial surge from the defensive line. But twice you see Mariota try to break contain, and twice you see defensive guys fighting to get him back in those vice angles, keep him pinned inside. That, and the defensive coordinator, Jeremy Atwell, enjoyed sitting down with him yesterday. He has done a great job. Charlie Stubbs has done a great job of keeping these guys playing and playing hard.
That was the first time the Oregon offense did not score. Henderson scrambling. Henderson will run out of bounds inside the 45. An 18-yard scramble there for Kalen Henderson. Got out of bounds, stopped the clock.
on Nicholls, you'd love to see him go in with 10 on the board at halftime, as hard as they fought here throughout this first half.
Henderson comes to Washington. Washington, a spin move. Gets 8 on first down, 2nd and 2. Tyson Coleman and Dior Mathis combine for the tackle. Clock continues to run here now at 25 seconds. The handoff to Hilliard Jr. And Hilliard will get the first down. That'll stop the clock. One timeout remaining for Nicholls. 15 seconds.
Three, actually, and they just used their first one. You know,
that is the third and final timeout taken by Nicholls here with 16.7 seconds. James, you've talked about this. We've talked about Johnny Manziel. He made his return to college football. Marcus Mariota. There is a connection between these two besides what they did on the field last year as redshirt freshmen.
Absolutely. They were both on their way to Eugene. Johnny Manziel had committed. There are pictures of him all over the internet with his Ducks gear on from his visit up here. Manziel backs out, ends up there with Kevin Sumlin in College Station. The rest is history there. Freshman winning the Heisman Trophy, and Marcus Mariota has done his thing as well. And remember, not playing a lot there late in the games last year, and those numbers are very, very close. This will be a fun year to watch both of those guys.
16 seconds to go here in the half. Henderson comes near sideline, incomplete to Damon Bolts. 13 seconds left. Okay, so if you're Nicholls right now, you've got no timeouts remaining, 13 seconds to go. Are you taking a shot towards the end zone? Are you trying to get the field goal range? What are you doing?
Well, you'd like to see a guy there in 12 who actually looked like he belonged at the end of the year against Oregon State last year. Great athlete. Catch that one. Get you a few yards and get out of bounds. Now you get try to get half right now and see what you've got on the clock. Remember, new rule this year as well, you can't throw the ball incomplete with 3 seconds left.
The pass comes, and that is nearly picked off by Dior Mathis. It hit the ground, though.
You can't kill the ball as you come up over the center, and now you've got to get yourself just in position where you got to just get within field goal range to get some points out of this at least. Lucky to get away with this one, though.
So it's 3rd and 10. And the clock here on the scoreboard says 6.4 seconds. And if it's 6.4 with no timeouts, you're thinking, got to take a shot to the end zone. Henderson trying to buy some time. Throws incomplete. Eric Buchanan, the intended receiver, on the clock here at the scoreboard. There is 0.3 seconds remaining. So they're going to bring in Andrew Dolan for a field goal attempt.
Andrew Dolan to attempt field goal.
It's going to be a 49-yard field goal attempt. He connected from 35 earlier. That is no good. Wide right. 38-3. Number 3 Oregon leading Nicholls at the half.
The uptick in
football is presented by Geico. Back here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, the number 3 ranked Oregon Ducks leading Nicholls 38-3. And hello again, everybody. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates. And James, when you think about it,
at the half. This is pretty much what we expected.
Pretty much what we expected, and pretty much what a lot of people hoped. If you're an Oregon Duck fan, you hope they didn't forget how to excite. We know that. We've seen DeAnthony Thomas, Marcus Mariota do their things, but we've also seen some guys like Braylon Addison on the outside hoping that he would be the next guy. He's been special. Defensively, Tony Washington has done a good job in filling in for guys like Deion Jordan, and if you're a Nicholls fan, you're excited that your team is making you proud and fighting in this football game.
Well, let's find out what the coaches think. Let's go down to Brady Papinga.
Yeah, I talked to Charlie Stubbs and Mark Helfrich at the half. Charlie Stubbs says that he would like his team to finish a little bit better. He felt like he had some good drives going and some nice stops with his defense with Mark Helfrich. He just wants to see that start that they had at the beginning of the game continue through the game. He felt like it tapered off a little bit there before the second half. Guys?
All right, thanks, Brady. By the way, try to stay cold down there, okay?
Trust me, man, I'm in the shade. I'm feeling good. I can't lie. I got the best seat in the house when you're talking about watching this game, although it is a little bit lopsided.
Can't we get him some of Goose's Hawaiian shirts or something like that?
Oregon will kick off to start this third quarter. Damon Boltz, Kerry Forts in our back tee with Matt Logan kicking off for the Ducks. Damon Boltz, the good return man, got crunched, stayed on his feet, and brought it up to the 19-yard line.
Justin, one of the bright spots for this Nicholls Colonels team, Marcus Washington, the senior running back, as advertised, can catch the ball out of the backfield, can run it and run it hard, decide he's going to get 3 or 4 yards, make up his mind to do it. And he is tough. Look at him go head gear to head gear with Tony Washington. I've really been impressed. He has set the tone. A slow start for a Nicholls team, but when number 44 got his feet underneath him and started going, got lathered up, the team really followed him.
Kalen Henderson is in at quarterback. Came in after Bo Hebert was knocked out. And the handoff is to Washington up the middle, lowers that shoulder. And Washington is very close to that first down marker.
I think you see the difference in the two backs for Nicholls. You watch Dalton Hilliard run the ball. Dad was a great player in the NFL. He dances a little bit in the backfield. Marcus Washington, north and south right now, go get it. That's what he does, and that's the difference. It's a microcosm of college football. That's the difference between a great back and a good back at schools all across the country.
Second down and one. Improving every year on the ground is Washington. Hand off on second and one. He gets the first down. You know what I like about watching him? He's kind of one of those throwback backs where you just give him the ball, he's going to go nothing fancy, but he's going to get you the yards with the effort.
And it's an offense that goes through him, but not just the plays he makes, but the way he plays. And it had, you had to have a spark if you're on that Nicholls Colonels team, and that's him right now.
Dalton Hilliard Jr. now in the backfield. Henderson rifles one, hard hit, but hung on to by Terry Lucas Jr. Ifo Ekpre-Olomu with the hit, but how about Lucas hanging on?
I love the throw by Kalen Henderson, threading the needle on that one. What do you think, James?
I think it's a great job, and we're seeing why Kalen Henderson was slated to share a few snaps and not just a backup to Bo Hebert. I also think, guys, that's a good no-throw on the flag right there. That's a good clean hit. It was underneath the helmet right there at the shoulder level, and a nice first down here on the opening drive in the second half.
And a flag comes in.
Illegal substitution. 5-yard penalty in the offense. Broke the huddle with 12 players.
But guys,
first down.
You've got some great stuff going. We saw throughout the first half. This is Colonels beating Colonels for Charlie Stubbs. Is it not, Brady? Killing momentum.
Oh, you hit the nail right on the head there, James, because I talked with Charlie right out of halftime. His number one thing was we got to finish these drives. And when you have these pretty much unforced penalties, what you saw there with Nicholls, they just really put a kink in your plans of trying to get a drive together.
So now it's first and 15. Marcus Washington is back in at running back. Henderson stepping up, facing pressure, gets tripped up in the backfield. by Tony Washington. A loss of two with a set.
And these spread teams, when you see them go empty like you just saw there with Nicholls, that's one of their main plays, is that quarterback draw. You see the Kalen Henderson there drop back and just trying to get the rush upfield and find a little gap in the rush, and was unable to beat the speed of Oregon. That's what they got up front, guys. They got speed all over the field when you talk about Oregon.
But he needs to follow in line with Marcus Washington. When he decides he's going to go get me a few right now.
Second down and 17. Anderson, he's going to throw this one into the ground. Intended for Washington, saw the pressure coming, didn't have anything, and wisely threw it away.
And I love those kind of blitzes there, James. That's what you call an overload blitz.
And that's one way to disrupt a screen pass. Good job of seeing what they're trying to do to you. And just knock out not only the quarterback, but the back as well. Nothing going.
Kalen Henderson trying to draw the late hit against Boseko Locombo. No flag, so it's third and 17.
I'm thinking here with Oregon, they're going to drop eight. Actually, they're going to show like they're going to bring the house and do what they call a little perception blitz. They're going to make it seem like they're blitzing and drop eight. We'll see.
And a timeout taken here by Nicholls. And guys, I got to be honest, facing a third and 17, I don't quite get why you use a timeout right here. But it is a timeout for Nicholls, trailing 38-3 here in the third quarter.
Money.
38-3 over Nicholls here in the third quarter. And third and 17 coming up here for the Colonels. Hilliard in at tailback. Anderson, air it out down the sideline. There's a lot of contact, and there's the flag. Troy Hill covering Kerry Fortson. And remember, Troy Hill came in for Terrence Mitchell, who was ejected for targeting.
Pass interference, defense, number 13. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, an automatic first down.
Well, Troy, we've bragged on you throughout the day, and here you've got to trust what I know Nick Aliotti and John Neal have worked all camp long, all summer long. He is right there in his hip pocket, stride for stride. When Fortson's eyes get big, when his hands go up, just snap that head around and intercept the football. Oh, what a treat to sit down with that gentleman right there, Nick Aliotti. 21 years he's been a coach here at Oregon.
On first down, Henderson designed run. And Henderson, a good run on first down, gets 9 yards, tackled by Derek Malone.
And Nick Aliotti, you know, sitting up there and all the fun he'd have, he'd get a little frustrated with this or that, and he'd go off on a tangent. That's the kind of thing that can give a coach headaches all night long. You've got a team in third down and 17. You got a chance to get your offense back out on the field, let them do their thing. And you give them a cheap, there's nothing you can call against this defense and get a third and 17 just like that, except for a penalty.
Second down and one. Washington back in at tailback. They give it to him. And Washington gets spun around, second effort, pushing the pile, and he gets the first down. Boseko Locombo.
Justin, watch Locombo. This is one thing you got from Deion Jordan last year. You run away from them, and they're so fast that usually you leave a guy unblocked, and you're going to be able to hit that line. You're going to be able to do something. They just end up chasing. Maybe they tackle for 3 yards, but they're making tackles for loss.
Did you see at the end of that play, Locombo kind of patted Washington on the head, saying, you know what, I respect the effort.
And he should. That's good to see.
Henderson throws, and that's incomplete, overthrowing his intended receiver, Eric Buchanan.
Justin, I'm impressed with this offensive line. When Oregon is trying to get there with three guys, four guys, they're holding their own and giving Kalen Henderson some time.
It's just tough to get open in this secondary. Four starters back on the offensive line from last year. That's the good news. The bad news is they gave up 42 sacks. Only two teams in the FCS allowed more, but it certainly doesn't look like a weak offensive front this year.
Nicholls out of the Southland Conference. Hilliard in the backfield. And that ball is deflected at the line by Eric Armstead. Time for a Lowe's Never Stop Improving game break. Let's go back to Patrick O'Neill.
Okay, Justin, thanks a lot. Top rank Alabama at Va Tech. Now, Virginia Tech down 14-0 until the freshman Trey Edmonds goes 77 yards to the house. He's got them young legs. Now, something to think about. Last time an unranked team beat an AP preseason number one, 1981. Long time. Justin, James, back to you.
1981, that is a long time ago. As a matter of fact, so long ago that Dennis Erickson, now the offensive coordinator for Utah, that was the last time he was an offensive coordinator. Empty backfield here for Henderson. Over the middle, incomplete, into double coverage. A couple of ducks collide. It's Ekpre Olumu and Oseke Lokombo. Those are two key players on defense for Oregon.
And I like this by Charlie Stubbs. He's going for it right here on 4th and 10, guys. Getting aggressive. He feels like they have a good drive going. He'd like to see it finished off.
It would be a 51-yard field goal if they tried for that. We saw Dolan miss from 49 to end the half. 4th and 10. They converted before thanks to a penalty on 3rd and 17. A late entry here by Terry Lucas.
Guys.
And now another timeout has to be burned by Nicholls. That's their second timeout of this drive. One coming on 3rd and 17. The other now coming on 4th and 10. Colonels beating Colonels. And you can see Charlie Stubbs is not happy with his offense right now in what just took place. Wednesday, the Ultimate Fighter will be right here on Fox Sports 1. World champion Ronda Rousey and Miesha Tate bring their rivalry to the house as coaches. And for the first time ever, women will compete along with the men to see who can become the Ultimate Fighter. The new season, the Ultimate Fighter premieres Wednesday, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on Fox Sports 1. 4th and 10. And here's the punt by Henderson. And that will be downed at the 1 yard line. Brad Nelson able to down it at the one, a 30-yard at the one.
Good job by a receiver there to get down on special teams and doing things other than catching the football. Well, that's what these Ducks receivers specialize in. Keenan Lowe, bottoming screen. Watch up top now. Braylon Addison, he doesn't just catch touchdown passes. He makes touchdowns happen. They fight beyond the whistle. Here's the best block of the day right here. Fighting, staying on, and look at the Anthony Thomas setting it up and being patient with his vision.
Mariota from his own end zone completes the pass to Josh Huff. TJ Lumar.
We talked with Scott Frost, Mark Helfrich's offensive coordinator. And as we take a look at what Helfrich had to tell us, you know, you can tell when a guy's not selfish.
Anthony Thomas, a couple of nice moves, gets taken down.
Justin, when he's giving his all on special teams, when he's giving his all blocking like that, and these linemen do the same, and Scott Frost, that's one thing those guys at Nebraska did when he won a national championship. The receivers blocked. He said if you can get them to take pride in it, that's the biggest thing, and they certainly take pride in it.
Second down and one. Helfrich was yelling at Laierla. A handoff to Thomas. Thomas gets ripped down by the shoulder by Davin Bovey. Gets enough for the first down. You talk about Scott Frost. There he is. First year as the offensive coordinator. Quarterback for that 97 national championship team from Nebraska.
He was a defensive coordinator at Northern Iowa. Kind of interesting. You don't see that very often.
Mariota lost one, completes to Keenan Lowe. Lowe down the sideline. And he gets taken down all the way down at the 20-yard line by Jordan Hanbury. A 40-yard completion and beautiful touch by Mariota.
You gotta love his progression read there. He had Addison out in the flat that was covered, and then went to a secondary receiver and caught him down the sideline. Nice play by Mariota.
And off inside to Thomas, tackled by Joe Bonner.
And Brady, I love the saying, no block, no rock. We just highlighted him blocking earlier today, and well, you do your block and you get the rock for a big play there.
There's nothing like having an incentive, especially for these wideouts, because generally wideouts, James, I don't know how, from your history, but some wideouts I ran into are what they call pre-Madonnas.
Oh, yeah. To hand off to Thomas again. And guys, Thomas is showing me something here today. Again, we talked about it at the beginning, but he's not always running to the outside. He's running between the tackles in this game.
And to me, that's one of the bigger surprises, because their run game, talking about Oregon, is based off of edges, meaning they want to get those guys like DeAnthony Thomas out into space, because that's where they feel like they have an advantage. But he's done an excellent job, like you pointed out, Justin, of taking up inside of those tackles and running tough.
Third down and five, 129 yards on the ground for Thomas. Now Thomas catches the ball out of the backfield and gets pulled out of bounds by Jordan Hanbury, completion of two.
And I like that call by Nicholls right there, bringing an edge rusher, as a corner actually, off of the field blitz, causing a quick throw, and they're able to get him down before he gets a first down. That's just a great blitz slash tackle.
So
right
now
there,
it's fourth and three, and they're going for it. Thomas is not going to break free from Jordan Hanbury. And again, this Nicholls defense comes up with a stand, and the offense loves it, cheering for them on the sideline.
And I can tell you what, this sideline down here on Nicholls side just exploded after number 16 had a nice tackle for loss there. That was a big play.
Brady, they should. That's a victory. It's 38-3. This is a team that will open the season with three FBS football teams. They looked ugly at Oregon State last year. Here, we're going to watch this. Watch the linebacker up here, up top for Nicholls. He's going to come and take the block. He doesn't make the tackle. But he sets that hole right there. He takes on, doesn't get blown out of there to make the gap any bigger. And then the guy's coming back and penetrating, make the tackle.
I'll tell you, the guy most excited on the sideline of Nicholls was their D coordinator, Coach Atwell. He was throwing his headset up all over the place. It was exciting to watch.
5 second play clock to 25 seconds. Start the clock on my whistle. Thank you.
Nicholls will take over here now after the big stop on defense by Jordan Hanbury. On first down, the handoff to Hilliard. Good run. And Hilliard gets up to the 23-yard line. Sets up second down and two after the 8-yard gain.
Hey, James, you know what I like about Hilliard? Is that he is what they would call a little short. And not that trying to knock on the guy, but those short running backs, James, you play Mike linebacker, you're playing off the ball, they tend to get caught up behind those big mammoth offensive linemen. You almost lose them.
Hey, guys, there's nothing wrong with being a little short. Second down and two. Play action. Henderson on the run, completes the pass to Devon Bolt. And now, another first down here for Nicholls.
Now keep this going. That's what they haven't been able to do, is be consistent. Be consistent. Don't get a 5-yard penalty. Don't get stopped for a 3-yard loss. Keep chipping away. This is impressive.
And I like how they're moving the quarterback and moving that pocket to just somehow neutralize that pass rush of Oregon. And also, they're doing a nice job of being able to get out of space and make plays downfield.
First and 10 here. Marcus Washington back in for the Colonels. Henderson can't escape the pressure this time. Eric Armstead brings him down for a loss of five with a sack.
You mean the basketball player Eric Armstead? Wow, looks pretty good for a guy that spends half his year over on the hardwood. And a good job here. He does such a good job with his hands. He even gets held there and just strong enough to come ripping through. He'll line up inside and outside. One of the reasons why they're so excited with some of these new faces that we'll see. Just a sophomore, great basketball player as well.
Second down and 15. Pressure coming again. Henderson gets rid of it to his back, Washington. And Washington is going to come up looking like just shy of that first down marker. Avery Patterson able to bring him down, his third tackle of the game. A 14-yard pickup, though, sets up third and one. And we've seen on third and one, hand off to Washington. You also have the option now with Kalen Henderson in there to keep it.
I'll tell you what, Kalen Henderson has taken on that leadership role, the general in the huddle. I see him cheering on his guys, getting in their face, saying, hey, we need to get this. You can see him doing it right now. He's talking to his guys, cheering them on.
Four wide receivers in on third and one. It's kept by Henderson, who has the first down. And Henderson gets out of bounds at the 46-yard line. A great zone read there by the transfer from Tulsa.
Oh, and a tough guy. He's doing it, guys, vocally, and he's doing it by example. We've seen him stand in there when the pocket's collapsing and being tough and throwing the ball. Here, cool and calm, doing what he does. Good read, tucking it and going. Put it on me. Let's move those chains. And this is a drive that now is staying alive with some momentum and some consistency.
I tell you what, I am so impressed that we don't see more fumbles on that zone read. I mean, did you see Washington? He was almost turned sideways as his quarterback took that ball away from him. Henderson dumps it off to Washington. And Washington has another first down.
Another thing that's impressing me about Henderson, guys, Oregon's playing a very soft zone. They're basically saying, hey, we're not going to give up the big deep play, the explosive pass. But Henderson's doing a nice job of just taking what the defense is giving them. A lot of times these quarterbacks get impatient, and they think, hey, I'm going to try to throw deep, test these guys out, and they end up throwing interceptions, or they put their offense in negligible yardage positions. But I like how he's dinking and dumping and taking what the offense, or I'm sorry, what the defense is giving him.
Marcus Washington has been pretty much the offense today for Nicholls. Showing blitz, hand off to Washington again. And Washington will get a yard. Combination tackle, Tony Washington and Havili Hamouli. Second down and nine coming up. 4 minutes left here in the third quarter. And this is the type of drive that Charlie Stubbs was hoping they could have in this game. Move the ball down the field. Take time off the clock. Keep that Oregon offense off the field.
But the really thing he wants to see that drive end in 7 or 6 points, eventually 7 with the field or the PAT.
Hilliard back in at tailback. Pressure coming. And wisely, Henderson just throws this one out of bounds. The pressure came from Rodney Hardrick, the middle linebacker.
And that's one of those Nick Aliotta specials right there, Aliotta specials, where he drops into coverage, so the lulls the offense asleep, and then out of nowhere, boom, he brings a blitz. And you saw Hardrick right there. He came Alioxin free in the middle of the offensive lineman of Nicholls.
Yeah, the new guy looking pretty good, getting off the spot and timing up the blitz there, guys. Hardrick, the future. Malone had a lot of tackles in the first half. Michael Clay had 101 tackles last year. He's gone now, though.
Third and nine coming up. Is this one where you try to make it a manageable fourth?
Absolutely.
Yes, sir.
But you see, this is, you can't have this. You can't have this and expect to go somewhere. You've got a defense, let's face it.
The third and final timeout taken by Nicholls here in this third quarter. The offense is on the field because Jeremy Atwell's defense came up with a fourth down stop. His team trails 38-3. Anthony Thomas, the star running back, 127 rushing yards on a career high 18 carries. Third and nine. After the timeout, Henderson will try to run for it. He's trapped, nowhere to go. Tackled by Locombo and Derek Malone. The outside linebackers combined for that stop. So fourth and nine is coming up. Down by 35, you could say decision time, but not much into this decision. Go for it.
On the road, you've played so well. You had a fourth down stop against the number three team in the nation. You get them on a four and out, then you put together an impressive drive. Absolutely, keep them out there.
try to make something happen. We saw a pass interference penalty earlier. They helped him on a third down and 17. Throw it up there. See if you can get a grab or even a flag to help you out.
Play clock down to one. They're not going to get this one off. Unbelievable. They've already burned three timeouts on this drive. Now you go from fourth and nine to fourth and 14.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
Now, we saw in their last drive, after a timeout, they punted. So maybe they're doing that again here.
And it was Kalen Henderson who came out and punted it. If the thought process was to go for it there at Alabama, at Tulsa, at Oregon State, at 29 years old, by the way, and at Louisville, Charlie Stubbs is an offensive coordinator. He'll tell you, you can't go backwards in those situations. You got to be ready. You can't let the clock run out.
Play clock down to three again. And they will punt. And again, this one will be down at the 1-yard line. Eric Buchanan got down there to down it. And so Oregon will have the ball from their own one. But the Ducks flying on offense, they're swarming on defense. They lead 38-3 with two to go here in the third quarter. And Nicholls. Oregon from their own end zone. On first down, completes the pass to Darryl Hawkins for an 11-yard completion on the first down.
John Lynch up there, larger than life. What a beautiful facility connected right here to Autzen Stadium. There's a shot of it. $62 million, the renovations.
That's the reported amount. Nobody actually knows the true amount. Another pass to Hawkins. And Hawkins will pick up 8 yards, tackled by Torin Joseph.
And Torin Joseph saw that the two guys in front of him to help were blocked by those blocking receivers by the Oregon Ducks. He flies to get outside leverage and force it back in.
Second down and two, Marshall in at tailback. The handoff is to Marshall, and Marshall will get the first down. Now Chris Berman and Ryan Bruno combined for the tackle.
Sorry, Justin. This is an interesting drive here for this Oregon offense. What do you have? Fourth and three. You just got stuffed down at the other end. You better put together a fantastic or an impressive drive right here.
Mariota keeps it. Nice move. Gets to the outside. Mariota all the way to midfield. Across the 49 of Nicholls, a 26-yard run. Such a weapon at the quarterback position is Marcus Mariota.
Easier said than done in space, but Byron Cobb, the only thing you have to do is stay outside. Even if you don't make the tackle, slow this guy up. Don't give him the big play.
The handoff. It's Marshall. Marshall trying to make one last guy miss on his feet. Touchdown. Nine-yard touchdown run for Byron Marshall. Alejandro Maldonado on for the extra point. In case you had the stopwatch going, that was 97 yards in 80 seconds. Byron Marshall, the stiff arm. You're not taking me down. I'm going to the house. Oregon leads 45-3. Back here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, our Chevy stat comparison. Just look at the yards per play for Oregon. 11.2 yards per play. In other words, they get a first down every play. That's what they're averaging right now. Kalen Henderson taking a shot down the field for Buchanan. Has it complete. and Buchanan is down at the 20. Troy Hill brings him down, saves a touchdown, a 56-yard completion.
And getting your first notch, getting that zero out of the plus 20 yards column, we saw that they were losing 10 to nothing. Explosive plays. How's this? Good protection, standing in there strong. And then you've got a guy that can get past this speedy Duck secondary. Look out.
Beautifully thrown ball by Kalen Henderson hits Buchanan in stride. That's the longest play of the game. Now on first and 10, Washington. He gets bottled up right away. I think if you spoke to many people coming into this game, if you said, do you think the starters for Oregon would still be playing in the fourth quarter? They would say no. But it's 45-3. However, you can see this Nicholls team gaining confidence, and they played very well here in the second half.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, if you're a Duck fan, if you're on that Duck coaching staff, you would have liked to have gotten some reps and some confidence from some of these other backups to get them some snaps. Instead, they're trying to fight.
Second down and 10. Henderson taking a shot to the end zone. And that is incomplete, an uncatchable ball. Time for a game break. Let's go back to Patrick O'Neill.
Eight go to Corvallis. Oregon State, 25th ranked, taking on Eastern Washington. There you see it. This is going to be the Eagles connecting Vernon Adams to Ashton Clark. Touchdown. It's now 13-7. So the Beavers, Pac-12 rivals of the Ducks, in trouble. Justin and James, back to you.
A Civil War meeting of Oregon, Oregon State, a huge battle here in the state of Oregon. One of the most anticipated games of the year. Well, now it's third and 10. Play clock is down to 2. Henderson has to get it off, and he will not. Another delay of game here by Nicholls.
Prior to the snap, delay of game.
The frustration mounting for Charlie Stubbs. They already burned 3 timeouts on that last drive. But Brady, how about the effort that we're seeing here by the Colonels? It leaves him speechless.
I guess so. It's good, Justin. You know, backing him up now. It's third down and 15, but still you've got 2 plays to move him.
Henderson low throw, and Washington cannot come up with it. So fourth and 15 coming up.
Well-coached defense against these screen passes. That hasn't been there all day. And even if the ball is held on to by Marcus Washington, he's going nowhere. You see the Ducks coming, and the Ducks coming with the proper angles. Look at that vice angle. That's pretty defense right there. Now you force the field goal try.
Andrew Dolan on for a 42-yard field goal attempt. Connected from 35, missed from 49, now from 42. And this is blocked. Tipped at the line by Dior Mathis. A good drive by Nicholls results in nothing, as Dior Mathis came through, got the block. And Charlie Stubbs, well, nothing else to say. How about this for a new recruiting tool for the Oregon Ducks? The Hatfield Dowlin Complex, which is just spectacular. 145,000 square foot facility. Home to meeting rooms, offices, lounges, locker rooms, spaces. It is spectacular. New quarterback in, it's Jeff Lockie. And the handoff to the tight end, Colt Lierla. An 8-yard run by Lierla.
That's a low. That's a little bit of a changeup from DeAnthony Thomas. We see the red shirt freshman.
Lierla again, you talk about a low. He just dragged a would-be tackler. Cole Frazier, who, you know, is just your typical 6'4", 240 guy, could be dragged for 5 yards. Jeff Lockie, 6'2", redshirt freshman.
It went back and forth between Lockie and Rodriguez throughout camp for that second spot.
The handoff to Marshall, and Marshall got tripped up. Hey, Brady, I want to ask you, with Colt Laierla running the ball as a tight end in the backfield, what is that like as a linebacker, seeing someone of that size line up as a tailback?
What I love about it from an offensive perspective is your multiplicity as an offense. You could run a whole, you could run two different offenses with the same personnel groupings, which causes major problems for defenses because they can't run in guys in and out to match your personnel grouping. So with Colt Laierla being able to run the ball in the backfield and also be able to split out in the slot, be a regular tight end, block in line, it just adds so much of a huge dynamic in terms of the multiplicity of your offense. It just makes, it really creates headaches for defenses.
And what he's talking about too is there's the chess match that is played. You can't match that guy. That's a great point.
Third and eight, Lockie. Dancing around, throws towards the sideline, and that is completed to Byron Marshall. And let's see where they mark this down. It's right by that first down marker, and they say it is a first down.
Well, I was hoping it was a fourth down and one. I wanted to see big 15 back there to get that 1 yard.
On first down, the handoff again to Marshall up the middle. Gets a yard.
And just to finish up with Brady's point, you've got Colt Laierla, who he can block and blow anybody off the ball in college football. Great blocker, as we're seeing here. Great running back. And he's also a great route runner. On third and two, who do you send in to match that body? Do you send in a big, strong linebacker to stop the run? Can't cover him out there. Really gives defenses fits.
Second down and nine. The handoff again to Marshall. Marshall down the sideline, breaks it free again. And he gets chased out of bounds by TJ Lumar. And how about the effort by that senior? Racing and saving a touchdown.
Good effort by the senior. And how about the future? Byron Marshall, LaMichael James, Kenyon Barner. It's a Duck Dynasty round. You really say, he gone.
Laierla in that tailback, takes it. Laierla rumbles into the end zone for the touchdown. A rushing touchdown for the tight end after the 47-yard run by Byron Marshall. And Alejandro Maldonado is on for the extra point. Yeah. 52-3. Mariota enjoying this one now from the sidelines. His team coasting to a week one victory. From the crew that brings you America's number one pregame show comes Fox Football Daily, featuring an all-star lineup of experts and NFL legends. Get everything you love on Sunday, every day of the week. Fox Football Daily, weeknights at 6 p.m. Eastern, only on Fox Sports. I'm guessing that a few of those guys, as this one goes out of bounds again, can do as many push-ups as the Duck.
Well, I'll bet you they can do more than Brady Papenga. You know, that is the biggest disappointment of this Saturday.
Yes.
Because back at the seminar, you said, Brady, I've got a great idea. You go do some push-ups, and we'll see how many you can do with all these points scored.
Yep. I wanted him to match the Duck push-up for push-up.
And well, dominated the Duck, guys.
Well,
what are you talking
Brady,
about?
Brady, no, let me finish.
Hold
you
on.
You said that you would, and then what did you say this morning? Guys, I might rip my coat, and I spent $200 on this suit.
That is a fact. I did not want to jeopardize potentially ruining my suit jacket, so that's why I decided to not do the push-ups. But yeah, I was more than willing, and I'm more than capable, guys.
See, you know what? It's a lot of talk, not a lot of substance. I'm disappointed.
Right. He doesn't toughen up. I'm not going to let him borrow any ties anymore.
Henderson, nice little scramble, got hit hard. As he goes down after a pickup of four, let's check back in with Patrick O'Neill.
Back to the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, top-ranked Alabama and Virginia Tech. This could be the play of the day. Christian Jones, how does he get through there? And he would take this one all the way to the house, 94-yard touchdown. Also had a punt return for a touchdown. Next week, a bye for Bama, but then at Texas A&M, September 14th. Let the hype begin for that one, Justin.
Wait. Patrick, are you seeing that people have been talking about that matchup with Alabama and A&M? Incomplete to Dalton Hilliard. That was in his hand. So third and six coming up.
Boy, how about that? Get to see really what you've got against a team. A lot of these teams kind of creeping into the season. You know, Texas A&M playing a Rice. Rice isn't quite as tough as a Virginia Tech. And Nick Saban's crew picked to win it all at the beginning, go for three in a row, and they look pretty good.
Third and six here for Nicholls.
Good job picking up that blitz. Good block, freeze Hilliard. And Hilliard then gets stood up. A 19-yard completion. And Joe Walker then stood him up. Dalton Hilliard, his father played 8 years in the NFL with the Saints, was actually a teammate of Bo Hebert's father, Bobby.
And I checked, and no relation anyway, as far as I could tell, to Ike Hilliard, great NFL receiver. Excellent job continuing to stay crisp, pick up the blitz there.
Play action. Pass to Washington, and Washington gets taken down by Tyson Coleman. You know what? Obviously, the story coming into this game was Oregon. And it's very lopsided, 52-3, which is what pretty much everybody had expected. But if you're this Nicholls team coming off back-to-back one-win seasons, you have to think to yourself, I'm pretty confident going in the rest of the way. We were able to move the ball against this defense. We had just one turnover.
And Justin, great job. Good catch.
And if Coach Charlie Stubbs is able to clean these things up, especially, they finished last year with a loss at Oregon State, 77-3. Went back and watched the game, and they looked nothing like this football team here that continues to fight today. And they're going to go to the final bell. So you've got some things, but you can also show some bright spots when you go back and watch film.
On first down, design quarterback draw. Henderson with a couple of nice moves. Gets up to the 26. Tyson Coleman there for the tackle. 5 yards on first down.
Coleman getting a few tackles in there. He listed at third string there, backing up Derek Malone, Rodney Hardrick, and Malone off to the sidelines already. They got in and got a good feel for it. Michael Clay and Kiko Alonso gone. Mentioned Michael Clay with his 101 tackles, 81 tackles for Alonso last year.
Second and five. Again, the play action. The rollout, the pass incomplete. DeMond Bolts got sandwiched. Eric Dargan with a big hit, and Bolts slow to get up.
Dargan doesn't go high. He stays low. And doesn't Bolt know it? This is Eric Dargan as a sophomore. Excellent job. That away, we've already seen a guy for Oregon and Terrence Mitchell ejected. He stays low, gets his hat to the side. He had to fill in for Avery Patterson when Patterson tore his ACL against Cal. He comes in the Fiesta Bowl against Kansas State. 8 tackles, 2 interceptions. Had 5 interceptions on the year. That's your backup. That's your backup safety.
And everyone talks about the Oregon offense, and rightfully so, but the defense goes completely unnoticed. And you think about the big games that Oregon has played in the past few years. Their defense has stepped up in a major, major way. On third down and 5, the pressure's coming. And the ball is loose, and it's picked up by Oregon. Raheem Castle on the fumble recovery, second turnover of the day for Nicholls. Terodney Prevost forced the fumble. Knocks it loose. The recovery, Oregon ball, and we come back leading 52-3. First time in school history, three players with at least 100 yards on the ground. DeAnthony Thomas, Byron Marshall, and Marcus Mariota.
Those explosive plays, they've had 12 plays over 20 yards today.
First down, the handoff. Is to Ayala Ford.
This is a guy who deserves all the reps he gets.
Jeff B.J. Kelly.
B.J. Kelly in the reception.
Here he is, Ayala Ford. 5'7", Justin. Not quite 180 pounds. Walked on. Earned a scholarship through his ferocious special teams play. Was actually awarded a scholarship on April Fool's Day. He didn't believe it.
And he didn't believe that as Ryan Bruno came right through and got him untouched. A loss of one on the play.
Again, to the final bell, Ryan Bruno. This Nicholls State University team, which you can call them, just don't call them Nicholls State, continuing to fight.
Going for it on fourth and two. Nice run by Ford. Ford cuts it back inside the 10. Ayala Ford, a 45-yard run on fourth and two.
Doing what they all do here, go get you a breather, just getting it outside and making them pay.
Now Kenny Bassett comes in as a tailback. First and goal from the 8. Lockie rolling out to his left. He's gonna run with it. Lockie to the end zone, touchdown. Seventh rushing touchdown of the game for the Ducks.
More consistent knowledge of this offense, football knowledge at that. Understanding, let that block set up, let that defender run into the block and cut it on back, barely beating out Rodriguez for that second spot at the end of camp. And there you go, youngster. First touchdown.
Maldonado with the extra point, 59-3 now, Oregon leading. The backups are in. The backups are producing here for the Ducks. First it's Ford, and then it's Lockie with a touchdown. Taken at the goal line by Ronald Tyler. And Tyler gets tripped up as he crosses the 20. How about the day for Marcus Mariota?
Well, there you see the balance in the numbers. Almost 3,500 yards of total offense for Mariota last year. Look at him put it up in the air to huff. Big pass play, and of course, those little shifty receivers know what to do on the short passes. And ladies and gentlemen, he didn't forget how to tuck it and fly on the ground, doing his damage as well, just as he did last year. 18 touchdown runs last year on the ground for DeAnthony Thomas's guys, and through the air, DeAnthony Thomas with 14 touchdowns. So much balance from Mariota to DeAnthony Thomas. These guys on offense, they're just doing it like multi-dimensional ways, like Brady was saying earlier with Colt Lierla.
All right, so it's 59-3, 6:31 to go. The question coming in, guys, was would this offense look any different without Chip Kelly? Brady, your thoughts. Has this offense looked any different to you?
No way. It's the exact same concepts. And the concepts are simple, guys. I mean, people look at Oregon's offense, they're thinking, man, this must be some crazy, complex scheme, and it's not. Really, the runs are based off of edges, and that all just means that they're trying to get the running backs with speed outside of the defense. And then their passing game is all about space. You want to throw the ball out to guys like Josh Hill in space so he can make defenders miss and turn simple 2 to 5 yard pass catches into 20 to 30 yard explosive gains and touchdowns.
A lot of flags come flying in after the conclusion of this play.
I'll try to follow up and let him tell us about this call too, but great point. And what happens with those explosive plays is that tempo. The tempo, if you have one guy against this offense that isn't set, that doesn't know what's going on, he's out of place. And we've seen from the speed over and over again, they make you pay, especially when you have the receivers blocked.
The player was pushed into the opponent by one of the opponent's teammates.
And Brady's right, there's nothing elaborate about this. And the thing that impresses me the most when you look at kids, these student athletes, is the ability to process and process on the fly. And that says a lot about these coaches as teachers, not just great X's and O's guys, but teaching them, making sure they know what's expected of them.
Coming up on 6 minutes to go, third and six. Henderson setting up, the screen was nearly picked off. David Coppavallo. And now fourth and six coming up.
Speaking of good coaching, that was nice coaching by David Coppavallo. Yeah, by just reading the screen, because I'll tell you what, James, if an offensive lineman lets you go to the quarterback, there's no free sacks. And you got to feel that as a defensive lineman, and he did that right there and was able to knock the screen pass down.
Oh, he's going to get a hard time from his teammates, though, in that locker room with a new coach, defensive line coach Ron Aiken. Only two new faces there, and he's done a fantastic job with this D-line.
A punt here. And this will be let go by Chad Delaney. It'll be down inside the 25. And we go back to Patrick O'Neill for a game break.
Northern Illinois lining up for a game-winning field goal at Iowa. Matthew Sims right down the middle from 36. Final score 30-27. Mack takes down the Big Ten. Northern Illinois' only regular season loss last season was to Iowa. So revenge sweep for the Huskies. Justin and James, back to you.
First and 10, another quarterback in now for Oregon. Jake Rodriguez takes over with 5:43 to go. Kenny Bassett in the backfield on first down. It's kept by Rodriguez. Rodriguez, he's got a big run. Across midfield, marked out the 48-yard line. And the Oregon Ducks are approaching a single game record for most yards.
And oh yeah, by the way, Jake Rodriguez, he's got all the tools, not just the wheels, but a big time arm.
Oregon now 27 yards away from tying a school record. The handoff to Kenny Bassett, tackled by Tyler Harrington, picks up four.
And you know what's really valuable about these games for teams like Oregon? Is the fact that they're able to get their young guys in, because these are really where the young guys get their developmental kind of reps, because it's only really in the games, James, to where you really get those reps where you make the biggest stride.
Segan Virginal, the player down for Nicholls. One of the keys to this defense for Nicholls, and you know, the starters have been playing the entire time for the Colonels.
No, it's not lead, he's just standing next.
T.J. Lumar said if there's a guy that he looks to in that secondary to be a leader as well, it's this man right here, Segan Virginal. Nicholls State University, located in Thibodaux, Louisiana, about an hour southwest of New Orleans. You may have heard the name because that's where the Manning Passing Academy is held, on the campus of Nicholls State University. And I know you're a big fan of Swamp People.
Yeah.
Not too far from where that was filmed. The pass comes near side to Chance Allen, and Allen has a first down.
Are you a fan? That's the question. I am. Watching him hunt those gators?
I love it. Oh, actually, ironically enough, a good friend of mine from high school, Brian Scope, was the producer of it. And I said, are you crazy? You're nuts. You're out there with these gators? Hand off. Bassett.
That guy's my hero. He gets to go hang out with those guys in their overalls. What is, okay, let's see how big of a fan you are. What is an alligator hunter's best friend?
Bleach.
You're a fan. That's because it washes off that stink. Huh?
I told you, I watched the show.
Oh, you do like swamp people. I got you.
Second down and seven. It's Bassett again. And Bassett looks like he'll be just about a yard shy. And they are rapidly approaching. And they have just set a new single game record for most yards. The Ducks on third and one. Another handoff, another first down for Bassett. Time is coming off the clock. The chains are moving. And the record has been set. Now they're just adding to it. Taking a shot wide open is Chance Allen for the touchdown. And they're 65-3. Chance Allen was wide open. 23-yard touchdown pass from Rodriguez to Allen. Oregon now leading Nicholls. 761 total yards by the Ducks.
Nice pocket there by the now backups in there, blocking in front of the third string quarterback coming in, Jake Rodriguez. Plenty of time. And there you see him showing off that arm a little bit, all the way to the corner, and Allen getting there inside. So Rodriguez, another look, and some guys wearing down in the secondary, and Nicholls too, just letting a guy run free down the sideline.
Well, actually there, James, I actually heard the conversation between the corner and the safety. The corner was sitting in the flat expecting a cover two over the top safety, basically saying that, hey, he was going to pass that vertical route off to the safety. The safety actually stayed inside on number two. So it was more of a miscommunication, I think, than actual physically breaking down.
Well, here you have, we've already had a record-setting game as far as total yards by Oregon. Now, trying to chase the most points since 1920. How about 1910 against Puget Sound? How do you think Puget Sound felt, giving up 115?
Yeah, Puget Sound wasn't a very good team, though. They really had some issues around that time defensively.
They were beating themselves.
Yes, that was Puget Sound beating Puget Sound.
The guys, imagine back in that day, there wasn't this fast break, no huddle style offense that we see today out of Oregon. They had scrums like rugby games.
Don't forget, we've got more football coming up here tonight on Fox Sports 1. Number 19, Boise State will travel to Seattle to take on Washington. The big storyline there is tight end Austin Seferian Jenkins has been suspended for that first game for the Huskies. So you're already hosting number 19. Now your job gets even harder without your stud, really all-American tight end.
Oh, big game for Washington, a lot on the line. Not to mention the brand new improved Husky Stadium. That'll be a great atmosphere to check out tonight between the Broncos and the Huskies.
That pass completed to Nick Scalfo for 8 yards.
And I'll tell you that Bronco program, guys, it wasn't too long ago that they were not even in the FBS, and they have just skyrocketed. And now this matchup, Washington-Boise State, Boise State's the favorite. about 10 years ago, it would have been completely opposite. It's impressive what Boise State's been able to do as a football program as of late.
Absolutely. On second down and two, it's Hilliard. And Hilliard will move the chains.
10 wins, guys, for the Broncos from Boise State in each of the last seven seasons. What Chris Peterson continues to do there. I'm up on the Smurf turf.
I think the thing he does most impressive there, James, is that guy knows how to recruit. When you've looked at the last few NFL drafts, Boise State now has produced some really good NFL guys. And if you want to take a look at one that's really good, look at the left tackle for the Denver Broncos protecting Peyton Manning. That's a Boise State guy.
Henderson unloads, incomplete, looking for Skelfo. Nick Skelfo, the junior tight end, was a second-team All-Southland Conference performer last year. This is a guy who was in high school a baseball and a football player. Loves both sports, but actually coaches his brother Ross's baseball team during the summers, and he just loves doing that.
And it sounds like you could tell he enjoyed ball and talking ball. We asked him, do you want to coach? And he went right into the baseball talk, so it sounds like he wants to be a baseball coach. I'm glad you got brother Ross's name in there, though. He was hoping we could do that.
There's a player down, Abasi Salimu. And he gets up the left tackle. He'll come off the field. Good to see him jogging off.
Salimu went to Crenshaw. That's where Anthony Thomas went to high school.
You know what amazes me? You see 6'5", 290. Nicholls had one win the last 2 years in Louisiana. How many people there are in this country who are that big that can fill out offensive lines no matter what level of football you're playing?
Well, Justin, there are. That's what they all want, defensively, offensively, and doesn't Charlie Stubbs know it? You know, there are a lot of big dudes down there in Louisiana, you know, throughout the South. But these other schools come in and they pluck them out. That's, he said, that's the hardest thing that we have trouble with is getting the big guys in, the big offensive linemen and defensive linemen.
Third down and nine coming up here for Nicholls. Under two to go. Henderson comes back to Reggie Wilson, and Wilson with a good run, able to get the first down up near midfield.
Oh, I love the mechanics there by Kalen Henderson, man. He looked left, faked the screen, and came back to right. Got the defense to bite on his initial pump fake. Great job. I've been impressed with him, James. I think he really adds a dynamic element to this Nicholls offense.
Absolutely. You hate to see Bo Hebert get injured again. He's had the shoulder before, the wrist. But we're finding right here in Kalen Henderson, just a junior, there's some excitement for the Colonels there from the quarterback spot.
Henderson lofts it, completes to Buchanan. Another first down as he is down at the 30, a 21-yard completion.
Guys, he's strong. He has really shown no fear standing in there, right in the teeth of these big pass rushers throughout the day. There he is on the back foot, lofting it up there and letting his receiver run underneath.
Are they saying no catch?
It's looking like an incompletion, guys. But I'll tell you one thing I'd like to see a little bit more out of Kalen. I'd like to see him get rid of that ball right when his back foot hits the ground. He's held on to it a little longer than I think that'll help him in the pocket, and it'll help his wideouts too.
Second and 10. Henderson again taking a shot down the field, and that's incomplete. Looking for Damon Bolt.
And from a receiver perspective, it's so difficult, guys, to be able to make a catch when you're anticipating that the defender's going to knock the ball down. And you saw that right there with Bolt. Bolt was expecting fully for that ball to be. It was tipped a little bit, but he looked like he was expecting it fully to be knocked down. And those are the most difficult ones to catch, because when they make it through, you're thinking, oh, that was supposed to happen.
Bronson Yim was the player who got back and just able to break it up. Third and 10 now coming up.
These backups for the Ducks trying to keep the Colonels out of the end zone. They don't want to give up that big play.
No flag thrown. Intended receiver was Skelfo.
In these situations, this, you know, you got all those starters on the sideline, and these backups can really feel it. Yeah, you've let them score three, but you take a lot of pride in keeping them out of the paint, and there are the numbers for Caitlin Henderson today. And Brady, you bring up the point passing it and just letting it go right now. It's that split-second decision that I'd like to see as he goes on throughout this season in the run game as well. Make up your mind right this second and go get me a few yards. Make up your mind and throw it.
Fourth and 10. Henderson dancing around. Comes towards the sideline, incomplete. And now the Oregon Ducks can run out the clock here in this one.
One thing I wanted to talk to you about, James. Get it. I wanted to talk about Oregon's new middle linebackers, because you know when they play Stanford, who's really Oregon's biggest threat in the Pac-12, they're going to have to face those two back runs. And that's a vital part of that defense, to be able to stymate those runs and get the ball back for their explosive offense.
Well, if you're looking for more sports programming, turn to Fox Sports 2, which is available on all TV providers. Go to FoxSports1.com to find out what channel Fox Sports 2 is on in your area. Dustin Haynes to take over as the quarterback. And the handoff to Lane Roseberry as the clock continues to wind down.
Brady, I like the way you think, because Mark Helfrich and his staff, another thing offensively, on fourth down and three, going in against Nicholls, they got stuff. It's that power game. Are you going to be ready when you run into a big power offense with a team like Stanford?
Stick around.
Another handoff to Roseberry. And that will be a first down, so it's going to stop the clock.
Chris Berman's going to have to leave the game for the last play as his helmet came rolling off.
That is subject to a 10-second runoff.
All in all,
reset the clock to 5 seconds.
Pretty good opening day. Got to see a lot of things. Coach Mark Helfrich is the head man. He's 1-0. Even shaking hands with all the officials, making sure he has some friends here in the Pac-12.
They will not get the final playoff. That will do it. 66-3, Oregon defeats Nicholls. 760.